Right, here we go. So you always wanted another gig log. Here we go. This is an event I'm doing. It's a corporate event near Potter's Bar, just outside London. It's for a company, about 500 people, and they have, as you can see, main stage. Cool flow here. Look at that. Check that out. That is so neat. I'm in here with another gentleman. We're doing the silent disco. Bit of a buzz going on here at the moment. We just started, so plenty of bit of 70s at the moment. We have Dinah Ross, Love Hangover, and a little bit of Fantasy after that. This gentleman here is playing a bit of hip hop. Is that right?
That's right. Yep.
Nice one. I've got the RX2 and you have the SX, I believe.
That's right.
Nice one. And Serato, there we go. Right, here I am, ladies and gentlemen. And what a glorious day. Okay, so this is where I'm going to be for the next few hours at least, in the silent disco. There is another DJ who probably gone for a nice cool drink. Is his setup rather nice? SX, Serato, and I have the RX2, and I got a bit of virtual DJ rocking. Pioneer headphones and no sound system, nothing. All you do is you use headphones. So how do you do a how do you do a silent disco? Well, the DJ will use his or her headphones as normal, but then you'll also have to use the headphones that everyone else is listening to. So that's pretty much like your PA system. It's like your sort of own monitor booth system, but you don't have speakers, you use headphones instead. So when you're trying to do a mix, you get everything ready here. You know, you start your mix off. Of course, you can just use your normal headphones, but what I tend to do, and what most DJs do who do silent discos, is you sort of switch from your headphones you're using with your kit to the headphones that you're going that everyone's listening to, and back and forwards. So, well, that's where people can lounge around. Let's have a look at our environment. So we've got a band playing at the moment. And there you go. Alright, back soon. So everyone has just had the main course, and as you can see, it's a very big marquee. We've got over 400 people in here today, and an exceedingly large dance floor. So just a very basic stereo sound, it just wouldn't work in here. So I've got system here, the other side, and then a middle bit, which is what I call the infill. So if you've ever watched any big bands, you know, sort of super massive stadiums, you'll of course see the line array right and left of the stage. But little did you know, possibly, that there's always a system in between. And you may have a whole bunch of bass cabs and just some monitors. They look like monitors, but they're basically filling in the center part of the stage area, where maybe people right at the front won't get any sound. So of course, if I have a dance floor full of people, you know, the sound would be adequate, but I want to make sure that it's adequate for everyone. So the speakers in the center, there's a single QSE KW181, and then on top I've got the K8s from QSE, and they're just 8-inch monitors. I use them in the room, but they're quite adequate for here because they're proper PA speakers. I've just got them set to run high and no bass. So let's see how it pans out this evening.